Please, just give my client this one chance. Please, give us with a quick, just one quick pro bono, please.
Sorry, petty with the prior.
Reviewing time is over. The court is waiting.
Sorry.
Department 1 of Moxingville Court is now in session. Judge Anderson presiding. Please be seated.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Calling the case of the people of the state of California versus Thomas Robinson. Are both sides ready?
Ready for the people, Your Honor.
Ready for the people, Your Honor.
Your Honor, and ladies and gentlemen of the jury, the defendant has been charged with the crime of first-degree murder of 21-year-old Don Craigson outside of 433 Brooks Lane on February 18th. The evidence shows the defendant's fingerprints on the gun as well as being at the scene of the crime, holding said gun in his possession. The evidence I present shows the defendant is guilty as charged.
Your Honor, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, under the law, my client is presumed innocent until proven guilty. During this trial, you will hear that no real evidence against my client. You will come to know the truth that Daniel Robinson did not commit said murder. Only from bad timing and a possible anger management issue, my client is not guilty.
The people call in Derek Craigson, Don Craigson's legal representation, and his own brother to talk about this painful experience dealing with this.
Mr. Craigson, you said you were shocked when you found your brother dead in the floor. Tell me about that if you can, please.
How can I even explain to begin? Let's say, okay, where it started. I was walking home from Hooters, and I see the cops at my brother's house, and I start walking over, and I see my brother. He's on the floor.
So, how do you feel about Daniel here when you found out he murdered your brother in cold blood?
I was just shocked, like, how could he ever do this to another man? How? He was a good man, damn it.
The evidence is self-explanatory here, since there is no other evidence to undo the information presented here.
Objection! Your Honor, this is humanely wrong. You are violating the Eighth Amendment!
Objection, Your Honor. I don't see the relevance to proving the defendant's innocent.
Order, Mr. Callahan. This sentencing is perfect for Mr. Robinson. Do you not know the laws in California? We'll declare Daniel Robinson guilty with two life sentences.
for free.
It isn't my favorite client. How the hell are you? Wait, you don't have to answer that. You've obviously been through hell.
Yeah, no kidding. I'm never alone in this damn prison.
Look, I've been in some pretty close-knit spaces before, but bunk mates aside, we have to talk strategy here.
The hell was strategy? Where the hell have you been?
Okay, you want to know where I was? I was busy trying to figure out how to get you out of here, how to get a good exit ticket. Do you even know how hard it was to convince these guys to let me talk to you? Let alone having you in this room?
Uh-huh, yeah, still doesn't explain the course of 5 months in prison. Were you even trying, Thomas?
I was slaving away at my desk, cracking at the living crap out of this hole you just dug yourself in. Local guy shoots friend over dispute, media frenzy, 10 years in prison, brother Murn's death. The news was crazy. Honestly, it's just a bunch of bullcrap. You and the story.
What do you mean? I was innocent. Why the hell did the case close on Derek Craigson?
See, this is exactly what I'm talking about. The story doesn't make sense. Everything from the trial to, well, even before that.
What?
Look, through my countless hours of soul searching, through paper mumbo-jumbo documents, PDF files, I found the report that was written on your behalf. You know, birth, residence, occupation.
Thomas, where are you going with all this?
Oh, I'll tell you. You lied, Robinson.
Oh, come on, seriously? I told you, I didn't kill him.
I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about your name. Daniel Robinson? Try more of a Davis type of a name. But look, it's better. You never directly filed that you were in the FBI now, did you?
Robinson was my mom's maiden name. I used it when my cases led to going undercover, alright?
Sure. The facts don't lie, Davis. Look, sorry for getting being so hard on you. I've been wrecking my head with this case for a while now. Funny enough, my brother's a detective. I mean, hell of a guy. But I thought I was talking to him, of course. Let's just say him and I don't exactly see eye to eye on career choices. Point is, your ties to the FBI, are you being accused of killing your own best friend, must be more than just a simple pass-by. There's something bigger going on here we're not seeing, Daniel.
Wait, you don't mean...
You know exactly what I mean. The trial seemed way too easy on the prosecutor's side. The court seemed like it wanted to get it over with.
Exactly. The court was swayed just by one side of the story. Don's testimony. His brother's testimony.
It seemed like whoever did kill Don wanted you to be the prime suspect and did so on the spot and wanted you out to take the blow.
Thomas, this is getting stranger. Blaming me for murdering someone? Yeah, oh sure. But it doesn't add up to the fact that I'm an FBI agent, and there being no federal backlash from this.
I don't mean to assume, but have you heard it all from Derek Craigson after I was put away?
Hey, what the hell? What about my situation?
That can wait. I have to make a phone call first.
Done.